Suratul Ala, and this is Makki Surah. And here we have learned how to recite it, Alhamdulillah. Suratul Ala, these are the shorter surahs we are doing from Juz 30th, and most of the surahs we completed, Alhamdulillah. Let's see the detail of this, and we are doing from Ibn Kathir. The virtue of Suratul Ala. The surah was revealed in Makkah before the migration of Al-Madinah. The proof of this is what Al-Bukhari recorded from Al-Bara. He said, the first people to come to us in Medina from the companion of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam were Musayb ibn Umair and Ibn Umay Maktum, who taught us the Quran. Then Amr bin Bilal and Saad came. The Umar bin Al-Khattab came with a group of 20 people. After which the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came. I have not seen the people of Al-Madinah happier with anything more than their happiness with this coming of Madinah, Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. This was reached to as an extent that I saw the children and little ones saying, this is the messenger of Allah who has come. Thus he came, but he did not come until after I had already recited this surah. Okay, they learned how to recite. Sabbi ismi rabbikal ala, this surah. And also in this, it has been confirmed in two sahih that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to said, Mu'az, why didn't you recite this surah? Sabbi ismi ala. And Imam Ahmad recorded from Numan bin Bashir that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam recite this Suratul Ara and Suratul Ghashiyah in two Eid prayers. Okay, we have noticed like every time Eid prayer is there and this surah will be going on. Eid prayers and fell on Friday. If Eid is on Friday, then he would recite them in both prayers. Eid and Salatul Jummah. Muslim also recorded that this is Sahih as well as it is in Abu Dawood and Tirmizi and Nasai and Ibn Majah. The wording of Muslims and Sunan compiles, he used to recite this Sabbi ismikal rabbikal ala, and they in even other hadith too. So we have seen that they recite Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam in Eid and also in Jummah. If it coincide both on the same day, then also. So let's see Sabbi ismi rabbikal ala. Sabbihi is from doing tasbih, glorifying Allah. Isma, name. Rabbika, your Rabb. Ala, the most high exalted. So Allah is most high exalted. Here this surah, we see the running translation, glorify the name of your Rabb, the most high. So we all here, when we start the surah with tasbih and we see like praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so we all should do tasbih. Why is it so? Tasbih will go when you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will go around the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala like a buzzing sound. And we all want to do tasbih. All the plants and birds and everything, they are doing tasbih. They are praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And because of your tasbih and zikr, you will have plants in the Jannah. Jannah is a barren land. We can make the plants. Now spring is there, we are planting the on this earth. Why don't we plant same time? The best thing to do, like when I was teaching to the children, I was saying, I remember we did one workshop like with the children, and when they were planting, we said do the tasbih so that you get the plant over there too. So it is a reminder for us when we are planting or when we are watering also, that time also it's a reminder. And I notice when we drive, that tasbih is going back and forth, that time it reminds, oh, we have to do zikr, isn't it? Like that reminds so much. And especially I notice when we are on the signal standing, and that time we recite more tasbih, more zikr. So zikr has so much importance, and it says it will remove your grief, your sorrow, huzn. And I notice it really works. Sometimes if you are very upset or so, if you're reciting your tasbih, if you do more zikr, it really relieves your tension and everything. Like some non-Muslims, they do some kind of yoga and this and that, but they release that stress. But this is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, who is the writer of the Quran, Allah. And Allah is saying, so subhanallah, we should do that. And here we'll move, glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High, and say, O you who disbelieve, say He is the Allah, the One. Aisha radiallahu anha added in her version that he would also recite Mawazzatain, Suratul Falaq and Suratul Nas. And here, glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High. The command to pronounce Tasbih and its response. Imam Ahmad recorded from Ibn Abbas that whenever Messenger of Allah would recite Sabbi Ismi Rabbikal Ala, glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High, he would say, Subhana Rabbiyal Ala, glory to my Lord, the Most High. Ibn Jarir recorded from Ibn Ishaq that whenever Ibn Abbas would recite Sabbi Ismi Rabbikal Ala, glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High, he would say, glory to my Lord, the Most High, and whenever he would recite, he say, La Uqsimu Biyawmil Qiyamah, I swear by the day of resurrection. And then reach the end of the Alaysa Zalika Biqadrin Ala Ain Yahyal Mauta, and it is not he able to give life to death. This is in chapter number 75, ayah number 40. He would say, glory to you, of course. Qatada said, Sabbi Ismi Rabbikal Ala, glorify the name of your Lord, the Most High. It has been mentioned to us that whenever the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to recite, he would say, Subhana Rabbiyal Ala. Okay, this is the Tasbih.
So when we say Sabbi Ismi Rabbikal Ala, then we have to say
Subhana
Rabbiyal Ala.
That's what Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said. Because we have seen two narrations, but with that time we can't, because already he is reciting and we are listening. But what when we listen. The creation, the decree, and the bringing forth of vegetation. Allazi khalaqa fasawwa. You know the next ayah, when we say Allazi hu khalaqa, he created, fasawwa, he perfectly proportionate, sawwa, seen, wow, ya. So here, khalaqa, who created, when zamir Allazi is there, this pronoun is for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, meaning he created that which has been created, and he fashioned every creation in the best of the forms. Then Allah says, Allazi qaddara fahada, who estimated, measured, qaddara yuqaddiru taqdir, he measured everything, and fahada, he guided. It's from ha dal ya huda. Who has measured and then guided? Mujahid said, he guided man to distress and happiness. Isn't it? Sometimes we are happy, sometimes we are distressed. He guided the cattle to their pasture. This ayah is similar to what Allah has said about Musa's statement to Pharaoh, Rabbana allazi aata kullu shayin qalaqahu summa hada. This is in chapter number 20, ayah number 50. Our Lord is He who gave to each thing its from it and nature, then guided its right. Meaning He decreed, set measure, and guided the creation to it. This is just as He confirmed in Sahih Muslim on authority of Abdullah bin Amr, that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, verily the Allah ordered the measure of all creation 50,000 years before Allah did it. He created the heavens and earth, and His throne was over the water. Concerning Allah's statement, وَالَّذِي أَخْرَجَ مَرْآ, He who brings out the pasturing, meaning all types of vegetation and crops. وَالَّذِي, and who? أَخْرَجَ, He took out. مَرْآ, the pasture, all the pasture, okay? And then He make it dark, like, you know, then after that, فَجَعَلَهُ غُسَاءً أَحْوَى, then make it dark, stubble. Like Ibn Abbas said, this means the ayah number 5, dried up and altered. And he has been narrated that Mujahid and Qatada said, all made similar statement. Means the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam does not forget the revelation. Allah said, like, you know, later on you see, sanuqarriuka fala tansa. Sa means will soon. Nuqarriuka will read, it's from qara'a. You know how we say qara'atul Qur'an, read the Qur'an. Here, qaf ra hamza means read or recite. Fala, so not, tansa, you will forget. So this statement, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, no, He is not forgetting. We shall make you recite, meaning, O Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, you shall not forget it. This is Allah's informing and promising him, who? To Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He will teach him a recitation that he will not forget. illa masha Allah, like, you know, illa masha Allah, innahu ya'lamu jahra wa ma yakhfa, like, except what Allah may will say. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did not forget anything except what Allah will. It has been said the meaning of Allah's statement, you shall not forget. Do not forget that which would be abrogated is merely an exception to this meaning. Do not forget, we teach you to recite. You know, Allah is teaching Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught to everyone, all the Sahaba, and from them we are learning. Except that Allah will, which He removes, and there is no sin on you leaving it, not retaining it. Concerning Allah's statement, innahu ya'lamu jahra wa ma yakhfa, means He knows what is apparent, clear, jahra, and what is hidden. We say that jahri salah, sirri salah. Jahra, it's apparent, okay, jahar. Yakhfa is hidden, meaning He knows the creation do openly and what they hide, isn't it? What we do openly, Allah knows. What we are hiding, Allah knows everything, whether it be statements or deeds. You know, whatever we are saying, even the deeds, everything, Allah knows. Sometimes, you know, we do deeds with the something else in the intention, you know. Sometimes shaitan incite you and say, oh, you are doing it and nobody else, you know, how he makes the other. So Allah knows everything. None of this that is hidden from Him. Then Allah says, nuyassiruka lil yusra, and we shall make easy for you for the ease. So here, we shall make easy for you. The easy meaning, we will make good deeds and statements easy for you. Really, we need the help of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Only Allah is making yusr easy for us. And we will legislate such law for you that is easy, tolerant, straight and just. No crookedness, difficult, no difficulty or no hardship. And then command to remind. Fazakir inna tanfa'ati zikra. Therefore, remind in case the reminder profits. Meaning, remind where the reminder is beneficial. Here, when we say for zikra, we know here, you know, for admonishing and reminder. In if tanfa'ati is from nafa, noon fa'ain, profit benefited, a zikra, the admonition or reminder. So, from here, we get the etiquette of spreading knowledge. Okay. We should spread knowledge. It shouldn't be like, you know, just keeping for yourself. Upon who are not suitable or worthy. The commander of Allah, believer, Allah's Ali said, you do not tell people any statement that their intellect do not grasp, except that it will be fitna, trial for some of them. He said, tell the people that which they know would you like for Allah and His messenger to be. So whatever we know, if we for sure, if we remember, just convey to the other people. The whose heart fears Allah, who knows that he is going to meet him. فَيَذَكِّرُوا مَنْ يَقْشَى. Who will fear, you know, with the zikr of Allah? مَنْ يَقْشَى. Those who have the admonition, you know, those who have fear of Allah. And then later on we see in this ayah, فَيَجَنُّبُهَا الْأَشْخَى الَّذِي يَسَلَّى نَارَ الْكُبْرَى ثُمَّ يَمُوتُ فِيهَا وَلَا يَحْيَى. In these ayahs we see, but it will be avoided by the wretched who will enter the great fire. You know, now the other way around. Wretched who will enter the fire, they will neither die nor live. Meaning, he will not die, thus be allowed to rest, nor will be alive a life that is beneficial to him. Instead, his life will be harmful to him, because it will be the cause of his feeling of pain and torment. That life is full of pain and torment. And you know, not only pain, torment, various types of punishment. Imam Ahmad recorded from Abu Sa'id that Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, concerning the people of fire who are deserving of it, they will not die nor they live. They are not dying or not living. Regarding the people that Allah want mercy for, He will cause them to die in the fire. Then He will allow the intercession to come to them. A man will take his groups of supporter and plant them. Or he said he will plant it in the river of Al-Haya. Or he said Al-Haya or Al-Hayawan or Nahar Al-Jannah. Then they will sprout up like the sprouting of the seed on the moist bank of a flowing stream. This was the mention here. And then Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, haven't you all seen the tree that is green? Then it turns yellow, then it turns green again. Abu Sa'id then said, some of those present said, it is as if the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to live in the desert, and due to his parable of nature, Ahmad also recorded that Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said, concerning the people of fire, who will dwell for there and die there, and they will live there. However, they will be a group of people, he said, whom the fire will burn due to their sin. Because of their sin, the fire is burning them. Or he said, their wrongdoing. So he will cause them to die until they become burned like a coal. Then the intercession will be allowed. They will be brought group after group. They will be scattered over the rivers of Jannah, paradise. It will be said, O people of paradise, pour down upon them. They will sprout like growing of the seed that is upon the moist bank of the flowing stream. A man from among the people present said, it is as if the Messenger of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to live in desert. And Muslim also recorded this hadith. And he then later on the other ayahs, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَزَكَرَ إِسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى بَلْ تُوْسِرُونَ الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا وَالْآخِرَةُ قَيْرُ وَأَبْقَى إِنَّ حَازَ لَفِي صُحُفٍ أُولَى صُحُفِ الْإِبْرَاهِيمَ وَمُوسَى. Indeed, whosoever purify himself shall achieve success. قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى. So we also do during the Ramadan time, we say we are doing tazkiya-e-nafs. So tazakka is from zakka. You know, zakat also, purification of the mal. Same word, zakka.
Zakat,
yeah.
Do we give zakat on diamond or platinum?
For the stones. But for the gold we give. But what more than, I think so. But I'm not sure right on. I'll look into it and let you know. For diamonds, I think because those are stones, it don't come in the gold.
No, but
platinum, inshallah, I'll let you know. So here, and remember the name of his Lord and perform salah. Remember the name means wazakara isma rabbihi. We all do the zikr. And also, not only zikr, and perform fasalla. Do salah, perform salah. And then, bal tu siruna al hayat al dunya. Rather, you prefer the life of this world. Allah is saying, you prefer this world instead of that. Bal is rather, you know. Wal akhiratu khairal wa abqa. Although the hereafter is better and more lasting. You know, akhira is khair. First word is come is khair. We know khair is better. And then also Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, abqa, it will be everlasting. And then, inna haza lafi suhufi Ula, verily, this is the former scriptures. And then Suhufi Ibrahim wa Musa, the scripture of Ibrahim and Musa al-Islam. The statement concerning the people of success, Allah says, Qad aflaha man tazakka means, indeed, whoever purify himself shall achieve success. Meaning, purify means characteristics and follow Allah and Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then, فَزَكَرَ إِسْمِ رَبِّكَ وَسَلَّى. And remember the name of his Rabb and perform salah. Here the established prayer in appointed time. You know, when you are doing prayer, in Quran it comes, you know, you are doing prayer but lazily. Never says you are not praying, right? So here praying on time, okay? Seeking the pleasure of Allah and obedience to his command and implementation of his law. We have already reported from commander of the believers. So this ayah. And then, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى ذَكَرَ إِسْمَ رَبِّكَ فَصَلَّى. Indeed, whoever purify himself shall achieve success and remember the name of his Lord and perform salah. Abu al-Ahwas said, if somebody comes to any of you begging, but he wants to pray, then he should give charity, zakat, before he prays. For verily, Allah the Exalted says, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَزَكَرَ إِسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. Indeed, whoever purify himself shall achieve success and remember the name of his Rabb and perform salah. Qatada said concerning this ayah, قَدْ أَفْلَحَ مَنْ تَزَكَّى وَزَكَرَ إِسْمَ رَبِّهِ فَصَلَّى. Whoever purifies himself shall achieve success and remember the name of his Lord and perform Salah means Fasalla, means purify his wealth and purify himself. The world is worthless in comparison to the hereafter. Bal tusiral hayat dunya, rather you prefer the life of the world, meaning you give preference to this world rather than preference to the akhirah. And it says, well, akhiratu khairal wa abqa, means although the hereafter is better and more lasting. The reward of final abode is better than the worldly life, means Jannah is better for them than this, because this world is temporary. We have to pass and we have to leave this world one day. And whoever love his worldly life will suffer in this hereafter, and whoever love his hereafter will suffer in the worldly life. Therefore, choose that which is everlasting over that which is temporal. So this is also recorded in the Hadith. The scripture of Ibrahim and Musa. Inna haza lafi suhufin ula suhufi Ibrahim Musa. Musa. So here, this ayah is similar to the Allah statement of Surah An-Najm. And here in Surah An-Najm, from ayah number 36 onwards is mentioned here. And it says, and Ibrahim who fulfilled or conveyed all that ordered him to do, conveyed. No burden person will bear. Of course, of his own sin, and man can have nothing but what he does, but his deed will be seen, then he will be recompensed with the full and the best. And this is mentioned in chapter number 53 from 36 to 42 ayah. And inna haza, in this referring to his previous statement, indeed whoever purify himself shall achieve success and remember the name of his Lord, offer salah. You prefer this world among although hereafter is better and lasting. Then Allah says about the Lafi Suhufin Ula and Suhufi Ibrahim Awa Musa, this view that Tabrani has chosen is good and strong, and also Qatada says this is the end of the, like, you know, means Suhuf of Ibrahim and Musa al-Islam also mentioned here. This was before the Quran. Okay, and here the overall, if we see the Suratul Ala, first of all we have seen the Hadith. This was recited by Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam in the two Eid, and also in the, if it comes on the Juma also. And also we have seen how importance of the Tasbih, and then how Allah Subhanahu Taala created, proportionate us, and then he made us guide. Qaddara fahada, only Allah can guide us. Ahdina Sirat al-Mustaqim. And also we should make dua, ya muqallibu qulubi sabbit qalbi ala deenik. Only Allah can guide us till we die. It's not like right now we are guided and later on, you know, it's not so. And then, you know, how the plants and vegetation comes and how they dried up. And later on, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, you are doing the things which are not beneficial for you. And also about Iqra, reciting the Quran. Here Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly saying he is not forgetting, it's a reminder. So he is reciting and we are also reciting, and daily we recite Qaratul Quran. That is so important for us. And also Allah is saying it will make you easy. Nuyassirul Yusra, you know, it is ease for you, isn't it? When we recite, it's easy. And also Allah make things easy because of this Quran recitation, and also when we implement it, Quran and Sunnah. And also, and don't forget the zikr, and it will beneficial for you. Tanfa, it's from nafa, you know, good for you. And this zikra is for yaksha, fear of Allah. We should have fear. A mu'min is in between two, fear and hope. Inshallah, I'll end in 2 minutes. And then, and after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, Allazi yasalla naral kubra. And who is in the fire? Because they are wretched. They are not believing and they are on the other side. And after that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned, you know, how important is that we should remember Akhirah, because that will be abqa, that will be everlasting. And this is very beautiful surah. If you can memorize it, that will be really good for all of us, inshallah. Jazakallah khairan kaseera. Subhanakallahumma bihamdika. Nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta. Nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayka.